Hello everyone, myself Mr. Siopa M. Metagar. I am working as assistant professor in computer science and engineering department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. The last two videos we have discussed about computer network and then uses of computer network hardware. Today we are going to discuss about network software. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to describe the concept of protocol hierarchies and state the concept of design issues for the layers. Agenda: protocol hierarchies, design issues for the layers, connection oriented versus connectionless services, service primitives, and relationship of services to protocols. These are the points I am going to cover in this video. Okay. About network software. Okay. Network software is now highly structured, because while transmitting any data from one place to another place, the user should have to use any one of the software. The fundamental idea is that here nowadays the software can be used for store and forward purpose. It means before transmitting the data, the user should have to store the data, whatever the data they want to transfer from one place to another place. Then after storing the data, they have to forward. If the data is misused or somewhere it is dropped then discarded, then that time the user have to check out the original data in the stored places. Protocol hierarchies. First, let us see what is protocol. Protocol is a set of rules that can govern the data communication between each other. Okay. Hierarchies, it means transmitting the data from one place to another place by using sequences. Okay. First point is to reduce their design complexity, and most networks are organized as a stack of layers, one below it. It means to the user can pass the data one layer to another layer, one layer to another layer, and layer below the layer, for hierarchy purpose. Okay. Interfaces. After transmitting the data from one layer to another layer, both the layers, present layer and the next layer, they have to interface with each other. If the next layer is free, then only the current layer can pass the data. If the next layer is busy, then the current layer have to wait. Okay. That both the layers, each and every time they have to use this interfaces concept, it means they have to communicate with each other. Then if it is free, then only it is possible to pass the data. Okay. Next one is a list of protocols used by a certain system. One protocol per layer is called protocol stack. Okay. Protocol hierarchies. A set of layers and protocol is called a network architecture. In the network architecture, we have to use a number of layers and number of protocols for different layers. That protocol can play a different role for different layers while transmitting the data. Okay. This is a block diagram of layers, protocols and interfaces. Here the user 1 is there in the host 1, then user 2 is there in the host 2. These two users want to send the data and receive the data. It means the current layer, that is layer 5, then how to interface with the next layer, that is layer 4. And then if the next layer is free, then only the current layer they can pass the data. If it is busy, the current layer how to wait until the next layer will be get free. Then after, if it is free, then only the current layer can pass the data. The same procedure they have to follow from layer 4 to layer 3 also. Then layer 3 is free, then the current layer, I mean the layer 4, can pass the data to next layer. Then again that layer 3 can interface with the layer 2, the layer 2 can interface with the layer 1 also. Then after interfacing, then they have to send the data to the receiver side through this physical medium. They can use any physical medium from sender to the receiver. The receiver side also, they have to use the same concept. They have to interface with each other. If the next layer is busy, then how to wait. If it is free, then only it can pass the data to the next layer. I mean, in a parallelly, both the layers are virtually communicate with each other while transmitting the data. This is a block diagram for layers and different protocols and interfaces each layers. This is how the user can pass the data. In the previous diagram, I said both the layers can interface and then they have to send the data. How they can send, how they can interface, and what they have to add. It means in this diagram, they have given actual data transmission. Okay. This is an example information flow supporting virtual communication layers. It means layer 5 want to transfer the data to the receiver side. How they have to pass the data, and then how they have to add the current layer information to that particular data. It means here it is there. This is M is in message. This message want to transfer to the receiver side. This message can pass the layer 5 to the layer 4. Both layers are interfaced with each other. After interfacing, it can pass the data to the next layer. This M or the layer 4 can add its own header information. H4 indicates the header, 4 indicates the fourth layer. That is, H4 can add the information related to the current layer. Next, if this message is divided into two parts, that is M1 and M2, it can pass the data to the different users in the layer 3, that means M1 and M2. M1 and then whatever the data is received from the previous layer, that is H4 is in data related to the fourth layer. Then H3 is in header about the layer 3. Here also we have to add H3, it means header about the layer 3. Then message M2, and then they can pass the data to the next layer, that is M1 is an original message, H4 is an information about the fourth layer, H3 is an layer information about the third layer, H2 is an information related to the second layer. T2 is an trial information they have to add before transmitting the data in the second layer. Then after preparing, they have to send the data to the receiver side through this machine. This is source machine and destination machine. The data can pass it to the receiver side. The receiver side also, they have to check out the whatever the process they have to follow in the sender side. That means T2, they can check it out, the trailer information about the second layer. T is in trailer, 2 is in information about the second layer. M1 is in message information, H4 is in fourth layer information, S3 third layer information, S2 is in second layer header information. Then they can pass the data to the third layer. So after processing, then it can send it to the fourth layer. Whatever the data is there in the sender side of the fourth layer, same data is there in the receiver side also, then original message will send it to the receiver side. Like this, the user can send the data by using the protocol hierarchies. That means sequence wise they have to send the data to the receiver side. Okay. So dotted line indicates the actual line indicates the actual communication, that is the dark line indicates this in actual communication, and dotted line indicates the virtual communication. Both sender and receiver, they can virtually communicate in a data communication or transmitting the data. Okay, in a communication they have to virtually communicate with each other. Design issues for the layers. Some of the key design issues are error detection. While transmitting the data, if the data is discarded, data is corrupted, where exactly the data is discarded, then we have to find out, that is error detection. Okay, in a error correction, after detecting the errors, the user can find out the how to find out the errors, and after finding the errors, how to detect how to correct that errors, they can use some different methods for correcting the errors, that is CRC and Hamming code. They can use the different methods for error detection as well as error correction. Second design issues, it concern the evaluation of the network growth, is that different network technologies often have different limitations. Okay. Third design issues, the resource allocation, network provides services to host from their underlying resources. Okay. Congestion, overloading of the network, it means sender side is sender side process is slow, the receiver side is high, then that time the user can face a problem related to the congestion. It means they can face a problem related to the spacing. Okay, quality of services is the name given to mechanism that reconcile these competing demands. Okay. Reliable connection oriented services has two minor variations, that is message sequence and byte streams. Message sequence, they can send the messages in the sequence wise. In byte streams, they can send the data in the form of zeros and ones. It means bytes, in the form of bytes, they can send the data. Unreliable connectionless services is often called datagram services. Means here we have to use different protocol, or one protocol, that is UDP protocol, that is datagram services, while providing the datagram services. Okay. Next one is think and write. It can contain one question, that is list and explain different services of connection oriented versus connectionless. Now pause the video and answer the above question. Now answer for the above question is connection oriented services, to talk someone, you pick the call, phone, pick up the call, phone, dial the number and talk and then hang up. Connectionless services is the model after the postal system. When the intermediate nodes receive a message in full before sending it on to the next node, this is called store and forward switching. This is a simple explanation about the connection oriented as well as connectionless. Connection oriented services are reliable message streams, reliable byte streams, and unreliable connection. It can goes to the reliable messages in sequence of pages, movie download, and then voice over internet. In a connectionless, unreliable datagram, that electronic junk mail, acknowledgement datagram, text messaging, request reply, database query. Service primitives. Primitives is a set of operations. It means a service is formally specified by a set of primitives or operations. While transmitting the data from one station to another station, the users would have to perform different operations that are connect. A set of primitives available depends on the nature of the services being provided. Okay. The primitives for connection-oriented services are different from the connectionless services. Okay. There are total 6 primitives are there that are listen. What is the meaning? Why we have to use a listen operations? It means block waiting for an incoming connection. Connect. These primitives can be used to establish a connection with a waiting peer. Accept an incoming connection from the peer. Receive, block waiting for an incoming messages. Send a message to the peer. Disconnect, terminate the connection. These are the different primitives we have to use in a communication. Okay, service primitives. This is a client machine. This is a server machine. This can be used for sending the data and receiving the data by using some primitives. These are the references I use for preparing the above video. Thank you.